www.youtube.com, www.google.com, www.facebook.com, www.instagram.com. All websites found on what we know as the internet. On YouTube, people post videos with both entertainment and educative value. On Google, you can search for almost anything that comes into your mind, and most of the time you get an answer to what you're looking for. On Instagram, people share their art and creations and share messages with others through just one photo. On Facebook, well, I don't really care about Facebook, so that's it for Facebook. But getting straight to the point, the internet as we know it can be one of the most trusted sources of data out there, but at the same time, it can be one of the most feeble virtual structures out there. This idea started to process in my mind upon reading an article on BBC.com centered around the topic of the world entering a digital dark age. The article was titled "Google's Windsurf Warns of Digital Dark Age," and it was posted 3 years ago in 2015. The very first line in that article states the following: Vint Cerf, a father of the internet, says he is worried that all the images and documents we have been saving on computers will eventually be lost. Moving on through the article, a statement is made that further reinforces this point. Our life, our memories, our most cherished family photographs increasingly exist as bits of information on our hard drives or in the cloud. But as technology moves on, they risk being lost in the wake of an accelerating digital revolution. I worry a great deal about that. You and I are experiencing things like this. Old formats of documents that we've created or presentations may not be readable by the latest version of the software because backwards compatibility is not always guaranteed. Now, this data problem is something that I have personally experienced, especially being someone involved in the field of technology and visual production. Recently, while doing work editing, there was a problem when rendering out a file in a certain resolution because the software would always crash when it got to a specific point in the render. Usually, what I would do is to move to a lower tier in the version of the editing software, then attempt to produce the same render. But since this newer version was released, the option to save for editing in a lower version was completely removed, and the coding of the save file was completely different. While some may view this as a somewhat microscopic problem, when the same thing happens on a bigger scale, it can prove to be much more problematic, very problematic for the matter. Even now in 2018, I am seeing articles popping up speaking of this same topic, the digital dark age. We may one day know less about the early 21st century than we do about the early 20th century, says Rick West, who manages data at Google. The early 20th century is still largely based on things like paper and film formats that are still accessible to a large extent, whereas much of what we're doing now, the things that we are putting into the cloud, our digital content, is born digital. It's not something that we translated from an analog container into a digital container, but in fact, it is born and now increasingly dies as digital content, without any kind of analog counterpart. An interesting point is made here further down in this article, and it points directly towards both forward and backward compatibility of files. Computer and data specialists refer to this era of lost data as the digital dark ages. Other experts call the 21st century an informational black hole because the digital information we are creating right now may not be readable by machines and software programs in the future. All that data, they worry, our century's digital history is at risk of never being recoverable. Photographers are or should be acutely aware of this challenge for their own digital work. In fact, there are two interrelated questions that loom over your files. How long will the physical media you're storing digital photos on last, and will your image files be readable on the machines of the future? As more and more new mediums of storage come into the eye of the public, older mediums of storage slowly become obsolete, and the data stored on many of these older devices may no longer be available to look over. Even the newer sources of storage can be completely destroyed. The reality is that servers can be completely wiped out or rewritten. And while I'm not saying that the internet will be completely shut down at any point in the future, I am saying that we should be aware of the fact that all data is not safe. All the information that we hold can be lost at any point in time. So it may be a good time to attempt to save at least some of what you have in physical form. It may seem tedious, but what is best for you is not always what you want. For more information about what I have spoken in this video, please refer to the 3 articles which I have linked in the description below. I am sure they will be of good use to you. Thank you for paying attention till the end, and I will see you in the next video.